Welcome to the Vigilance Visitor Center and Tasting Room, the uncompleted, non-completed one. Anyhow, we're going full speed ahead trying to get this ready for our grand opening October 30th. And starting at about 11 o'clock, ribbon cutting ceremony at 11:30. And anyhow, let's enter the cellar, the winery of the old ranch house tasting room.
Cool. And so Clay, we're about a month out, right?
It's a little over a month out.
Yep. So last time we were here, it looked a lot different. Finding old garbage cans and beer cans tucked away in the roof and things like that.
Hold on a second on the drill. Anyhow, we're working 1,000 miles an hour to get this ready. This is going to be the cellar. We're going to have some actual wine barrels in here. We'll be able to do some winemaker dinners, and we're going to also be able to rent the facility out for meetings and such. There's going to be a big redwood table that we build out of an old water tank, wood out of an old water tank that was on the property. And we're currently putting a ceiling in here and the old stairs. This place was built in 1931, burned down, but the basement or cellar part of it was intact, and somebody built it back up. But we're going to save some of the old artifacts. For instance, the old stairway up is going to stay in place. The rock walls are somewhat cemented. There's a rock outcropping over here. And we're just, you know, trying to recreate the old feeling that was here before. But this will just be a great place to smoke a cigar, if you wish, or drink some heavy, big red wines, have some fun, and welcome to the cellar.
Cool.
But come out and see the view. Rick Shields is a husband of Linda Shields. Linda Shields is our director of marketing and retail sales. Rick has a construction company, is doing all this work. He specializes in old buildings and remodeling old barns and such, and good guy, and has a lot of these ideas. We had an architect, Carla DeFeda, that also kind of gave us, pointed us in the right direction on this property. But we've refurbished all the old redwood siding. Again, it's built in, I think, 1931, but rebuilt somewhere in the late 30s, early 40s. But our tasting room is going to be here, just a simple kind of tasting room. We hope that we're going to evolve out of this tasting room and put it up in the Mercado, the general store tasting room winery at the old barn. And then this will become kind of a vacation rental bed and breakfast type of thing. Got the deck. We got beautiful Anderson Marsh out there, which is just breathtaking. And we have another little tasting room that we think is going to go up on the hill where that little vineyard is. And we have Gregory Graham tasting room. He's right around the corner here. So we're kind of starting to create a district here. We think, you know, the district of the marsh, the wine district of Anderson Marsh, Marema del Lago, the marsh of the lake, basically a wine tasting district in the Red Hills Appalachian of Lake County. We're going to be able to offer private tastings here in this separate little room. We're going to have some tables out here on the deck. Going to be, you know, modestly landscaped, more of an old farm and a ranch house, not she and not too high end stuff. Just natural stuff. Most of the garden is going to be edible, lots of herbs and things like that. And I guess the exciting thing, we're going to have, there's not a lot of places to have meetings in the county, but we're going to have multiple meeting locations here that you could rent. We could provide food and wine and such. We'll have the morning meeting place over here on the west side of the building. We got the deck area, we got below the deck, we got the cellar underneath the house. We got the feral gas tank over there that's going to be removed. So this is a great example of what we practice at Shannon Ridge and Vigilance here. This is really what sustainability is about. It's keeping people with jobs to have kids to feed. And, you know, these guys are generally foreman tractor drivers, and we have a really late harvest, so we're not picking any grapes right now. Generally, they're working, you know, 10, 12 hours a day. And so this, with keeping projects like this going on our ranches, building some rock walls, keeps these guys going, teaches them a new skill, become more value to the company, and it just adds value to them. And these guys are great. This is all a dry stack rock wall. We're not buying this rock. We're just removing it from a rock pile on the property that looks ugly, putting it in, adding some labor to it, keeping these guys working, and making beauty out of it. And hopefully they keep their safety glasses on, because that stuff is flies off there once in a while. But anyhow, Luis Fajardo is in charge of this property. I don't know where he is right now. He's close by, but he's taught these guys how to do all this stuff and everything. We're just trying to do more and more stuff in-house.
Great.
All right, so he's whining and crying, but here's Rick Shields. Here's a designer, construction head honcho around this project. Rick.
Thanks.
Yeah. You want to shake my hand on the camera, please?
You can tell he's a head honcho because he's carrying bags of cement.
He loves it. He's a good guy. Works hard, and anyhow, we're trying to have a little fun here doing some of this stuff, too. But what do you call this? This is going to be our, not a gable. What the hell do we call this?
Gazebo, or?
Yeah,
this
would be Arbor.
So this will be another seating area out here that we could have meetings and stuff. And then we got the two stainless, or our two tanks here. Rick's designed those two water tanks for us. And anyhow, October 30th.
Cool.
Be here.
Be here, huh?